Have you ever wondered where the sun came from? Why it rises in the east and, unfailingly reliable, sets in the west? You've heard stories about rotating planets moving in perfect precision. Systems that defy our concept of time and have existed in their perfection, set in motion by what might as well be commonly accepted theories, as a result of a series of great cosmic accidents, or maybe an all-powerful creator designed a perfect universe encompassing complete balance. All that is right, all that is wrong, bequeathing this tiny group on the single spinning object in space, the ability to choose our individual paths as so governed by the fortune of our health. And all the while, our sun gently rises. Our sun gently sets in silence, fueling our existence from one day to the next, long ago, regardless of the ever-present tipping, standing, steady, and unpredictable.
Long ago, unsteady and unpredictable, days sometimes of 3 hours, and others that burned endlessly. So that our delicate system was threatened, taking all that walks, sees, breathes, grows
their perfection for what might as well buy this fiery magnet of sun and the emperor of the earth, who wanted total control of the element, total control of time, total control. In his vanity, he headed into the sun. She sat waiting, uneasy stillness. It had been foretold to her, almost as a mythical story passed on through generations, that this was a myth. She had been entrusted with maintaining balance, so life and all its manifestations could freely evolve, soaking in her light and warmth, resting by the glow she gently projects on the delicate face of the moon. But her attention would divide.
Who wanted total control of the elements, who wanted total control of time. He headed into the sun.
Did he try to harness her life, stealing it away into his own hands? Did he try to siphon her heat, replace it with chill and ice? Perhaps he attempted something more insidious, something manipulative. Mind games of trying to persuade her with a saccharine smile and shady, scheming eyes that she should in fact acknowledge her weariness and indeed forgive herself with a sigh of relief. Stepping aside to allow another to offer her a sign. Steady and unpredictable. Some days of 3 hours and others that burned endlessly for so long that our delicate system was threatened, taking all that walks, sees, breathes, and grows. Time. This was the fiery battle between the queen and the
What we do know is that there were seven solar flares, cutting the significant significance of sort of fire ships.
But this was not it.
She had been impressed to go to the train and cut it so light. So was in the river, resting by the glow, she gently projects on the back and haste to the moon before they could fall, and her attention would divide. Tortuously back to earth, he entered, leaving a wound in the atmosphere as a warm fire punched and her mind an orchestra of tiny galaxies,
glittering
abstractly shimmering in the distance.
An eclipse.
A harvest moon.
A cinema of planets, singularly sailing
across her great tiny shadows. And most of all, the hope inherent in existence of being timelessly linked together. Equal but unable to sum, since our balance lies across the sky and the
space.
The Emperor, too, now bows with humility to the Queen of Suns, while she tends to his garden, patiently nurturing so he can have.
But unable to sum, since our balance lies across the sky and mysteries.
Replaced with chilly emptiness.
An orchestra of tiny, glittering
galaxies
of something
in
the short distance.
Perfect calculation.
An eclipse.
When she shall rise and set.
A harvest
wet
moon.
Below wet horizon.
A cinema of planets.
If we pay attention, she gives us immeasurable challenge of perspective.
And most of all,
an orchestra of tiny, glittering galaxies abstractly shimmering in the distance. An eclipse. A harvest moon.
Being
a cinema of planets, singularly sailing across her greatness in tiny shadows.
Of tiny, glittering
galaxies, the
hope abstractly shimmering
together.
In the distance.
Of being.
Equal but unable to sum, since our balance lies across the sky and mysteries.
The Emperor, too, now bows with humility to the Queen of Suns. While she tends to his garden, so he can have peace in its shade.
Patiently nurturing, so he may have peace in its shade.